You're the Rock at 60. And snoring? Sleep Number's even got an adjustment for that. You can only find Sleep Number at a Sleep Number store. Right now, you can save $500 on the number one rated i8 bed. No better sleep with Sleep Number.
Some phones aren't water resistant. Some don't have replaceable batteries. Some don't have a kids mode that prevents the little fella from sending out that embarrassing photo to the whole company. The Samsung Galaxy S5. It takes a lot of things to be the next big thing.
Hey, Ryan. You free for lunch?
Purchase a GS5 from any carrier or retailer in the U.S. and get up to $200 for your trade-in. Best Buy customers redeem in store.
It's back for a limited time. Enjoy America's boldest steak and classic steamed lobster or Old Bay butter lobster on the Barbie, starting at just $14.99.
And on Halloween, when you buy an entree, you'll unleash a free kids' meal.
It's a scary good deal.
It's Chevy Truck Month, time when truck guys can depend on great offers on the 2014 North American Truck of the Year. The Chevy Silverado. Stop by your local Chevy dealer today. Good breaking ball from Hatfield. Is he eating up some big outs here for the Giants? We start the bottom of the fourth inning. San Francisco up 3-2. Gordon with an RBI double. Good base running and a run scored in the two-run second. Eyes keep darting down to the bullpen for the Giants, and that name that lurks over this game seven, Madison Bumgarner. When he will get up, if he will get up, according to Bruce Bochy, if he gets up, he's coming in the game. Strike two on Gordon.
Talking about Affeldt eating up outs. He's chewed up four so far. His high for the season is six. As he said, I'm too old to go for strikeouts. I like to get hitters out of there quickly. As long as he keeps that pitch count manageable, he's thrown as many as 39 pitches. He can chew up some more outs.
Play by Joe Panik. Last inning might be the play of this game and maybe the World Series, depending on who wins here tonight. As you said, Harold, with a runner at first, Kane, who can fly. Nobody out. The ball ripped up the middle by Hosmer instead of first and third. Nobody out. Panik not only kept it on the infield, not only got one out, but got a double play.
That was a terrific play. Flipping it out of the glove did two things for you. One, it beat Kane in the bag at second, but it also allowed you to turn the pivot on Hosmer.
Oh, that hits Gordon in the back. Got away from Affeldt. And the second hit batsman of the night for Kansas City.
The breaking ball didn't come back.
Yeah, and this is, I'm sure Bruce Bochy obviously watching him closely, but especially because what I said about the outs, remember this too. He obtained the out to end the second inning, sat down, went out for the third, sat down, back out again. Very rarely will you see a relief pitcher sit down twice.
Activity stirs for the Giants in their bullpen. It's Lincecum again. Here's Perez, double play ball. Panik, the flip. They got them both. Second consecutive inning, the Giants' middle infielders have turned to double play.
And this is the difference between the Giants' bullpen and the Royals' bullpen. They will draw that double play ball for you to get out of an inning.
Check the running of Perez down the line. Clearly compromised. That's obviously all he's got, trying to beat that one out.
Not only running, but hitting him also. Doesn't have the legs to drive a baseball. That swing was basically all arms.
Here's Moustakas 0 for 1. Homered last night, has 5 home runs, which is a Royals record in a single postseason. A shift on the infield. Strike one.
You know, I find interesting with Perez not being able to use his lower legs, drive the ball. We saw it similar with Yadi Molina before he got hurt. We knew that he had the oblique injury. He dropped the bunt and moved runners up. We're all, what is he doing bunting in this situation? The next at bat he was injured. Maybe Perez moves up a bunt next time as well instead of trying to swing and run out of grounder.
One ball, one strike now on Moustakas. Jeremy Affeldt, a guy who's been part of what they're calling the core four out in the bullpen. Affeldt, Javier Lopez, Santiago Casilla, the closer, and Sergio Romo. They won it all in 2010, won it all in 2012. They lead here in Game 7 tonight, strike two on Moustakas.
Some credit to that man, Bruce Bochy, the way he uses relief pitchers. All these guys into their 30s, still effective for so many years.
Two and two.
In this day and age, when everybody thinks a reliever is just a reliever, he still strongly believes, I want you to know your role and when you need to get ready and when you don't. And I think that's huge. And we're talking about a lot with that guy in the middle right there, Madison Bumgarner, clearly a starter, as to once he gets up, he's in. And I think Bochy does a great job with all those guys knowing when I get warm, I'm hot, I'm in a game.
Moustakas, left side, right at Sandoval. He's there, got the out. Pitching and defense tonight since Affeldt took over for the Giants, who lead by one after four in Game 7 back after this from your local Fox station.
Sprint has done it again. First, there was the Sprint Family Share Pack. A family of 2, 4, or even 10 gets unlimited talk, text, and 20 gigabytes of data to share with the entire family for only $100 a month. That's double the high-speed data of AT&T, Verizon, and T-Mobile. Double the data. And now check out Sprint's new unlimited plan. Individual lines of unlimited data, talk, and text at just $50 a month per line. Our lowest price ever. Enjoy either plan with iPhone 6 for zero down. Sprint. It's the best value in wireless.
In backyards, sandlots, and neighborhoods across Kansas City,
you wind up for the bench.
The dream begins. For lifelong fans of America's favorite pastime.
Two outs, bottom of the ninth, and the game's all tied up.
We've been proud to support the Kansas City Royals and their loyal fans.
It's a long play to center, and it's out of here!
Especially the Dreamers. Hy-Vee, an official sponsor of the Kansas City Royals.
You've heard it 1,000 times before, but it's true. It's what's inside that counts.
Especially when it comes to the rugged 2014 Tundra. With its powerful available V8 engine and refined interior, Tough never felt more comfortable. It's capability and comfort you can expect when it's assembled in the USA. Get the Toyota Care lease on a new 2014 Tundra for only $299 a month, or get 0% APR for 36 months on a 2014 Tundra. Toyota, let's go places.
About safe helmets in football? New information that will make you open your eyes. Thursday at 10 on Fox 4. Fox4KC.com. The web working for you.
Now, as soon as this game is done, I want you to head over to Fox Sports 1. This camera's getting really close to me. For Fox Sports Live from Kansas City.
That's right. And tomorrow, join us for a one-on-one with LeBron James the night he makes his return to Cleveland. It's after the game on Fox Sports Live. It's your home for the World Series, and it's on Fox Sports 1.
Madison Bumgarner is up, getting ready as we play in the fifth inning now. Giants lead 3-2. Caps, hoodies, jerseys, jackets, and more. Get all the officially licensed World Series gear for the Giants, Royals, and all of baseball at the MLB.com shop. Herrera back to work. Ball one up and away to Gregor Blanco. Top of the order for the Giants. Panic and then Posey. San Francisco leads by one here in Game 7. The 1-0. In the air to left, well hit. Back to grab it for out number one, Alex Gordon, one away.
What a beautiful play. Looked like a defensive back. Watch him turn and run full speed and just runs this ball down easy. Here's a great look at it. He'll turn, open the hips, go get it. Almost like guarding somebody's running the out pattern on him.
He's got a great arm along with being able to go get it. He's got Gold Glove awards. Former third baseman, and now Perez gets another hit by the baseball as Panic tries to bunt. Foul tips it into him.
Well, he had him, too. Moustakas is playing back. Anytime you catch that guy behind the bag, that's a base hit for a bunter. I'd come back with it if, again, he's going to stay in that position. You're already thinking about it on one pitch.
Strike two from Kelvin Herrera.
This is some cheddar right there. You can almost hear the seams on these great microphones we have as the ball sizzled to the plate.
Bottom of the fifth, it'll be Infante, Escobar, and Aoki. Foul.
Just to reinforce what Bruce Bochy told us about Bumgarner, when he's up, he's in the game. Nothing conditional about that warm-up session out there. And how about Jeremy Effel? The longest outing of his postseason career, his longest outing since July of 2012. A huge bridge in this game provided by Effel.
He goes two and a third, one hit, all zeros. This is a foul ball. I know we've said it seems like 700 times already, but the guy at the plate, he's coming back to grab his bat. Talk about Affeldt all you want. He was good. He gave the Giants exactly what they needed, getting outs after Hudson couldn't get through the second inning. His line would look a lot different if not for the play by the rookie Joe Panic to his right for the double play.
That's a huge play. You know, you continue to talk about it because it's that big in a game like this.
Herrera with a count of 0-2 as out number two.
Herrera looks better tonight than he did the other night, showing the ability to bounce back, but he's got some movement now. This comes back, looks like a little changeup grip. The rollover, he got some movement. They've been trying to throw fastballs by Joe Panic. It just hasn't happened.
Here's Buster Posey, 0-2, 4 out of 24 in this World Series.
Well, he looks frustrated, doesn't he? A lot of swings and misses. Seems to be in between, behind on fastballs, out in front of breaking balls.
You're talking about a guy who has led two National League pennant-winning teams from the catching position in home runs in his career. This year, he led the club with 22.
You almost never see him take a swing with the hand coming off the bat. That's how far out in front he was of the changeup.
About 99 after the changeup, ball one.
It's not even fair. That's not fair, Joe. So 86 and then 99. Buster's in between, though. I like the conversation you two are having. He is in between right now, but it is one swing away for him.
That gets him over the inside corner. Herrera gets through the top of the fifth, and here he comes. Madison Bumgarner, already a World Series hero, taking over in the fifth.
It's Chevy Truck Month, time when truck guys can depend on great offers on the 2014 North American Truck of the Year. Chevy Silverado, from the family of the most dependable, longest-lasting full-size pickups on the road. It's Truck Month. Trade up to this Silverado Crew Cab LT All-Star Edition for a total value of $8,500.
It's Truck Month. See your local Chevy dealer today.
Who is the man that would risk his neck for his brother, man?
Can you dig it?
Who's the cat that won't cop out when there's danger all about?
Right on.
Lowe's presents How to Make It Quiet by Being Loud.
Save 10% off major appliances, $3.99 and more, plus 5% off with your Lowe's card.
What you got there?
Oh, Cheez-It Grooves. It's a Cheez-It, but it's light and crispy like a chip, kind of the best of both worlds.
There's more than one world?
No.
They're among us?
It's just...
You're one of them! Help! He's got a probe!
It's a pen.
We take the time for our cheese to mature in our Cheez-It Grooves.
That's what you had to do, okay?
Life insurance from New York Life can help your family keep good going.
If you're on a diet of taking it up a notch, drink Diet Dew, the only diet with dew in it.
Do you want to protect a one-run lead in Game 7 of the World Series in Madison Bumgarner? Coming off the shutout. Working tonight on his usual side day. And there are the overall numbers for a guy who's thrown 265 innings this season overall. He's making a relief appearance here. Last time he did so was Game 6 of the NLCS in 2010 at Philadelphia. Worked two scoreless innings, 26 pitches on 2 days rest. So far this postseason, you saw the numbers, 4-1, 1.13, and he's 4-0 in his World Series career.
I don't care if he strikes everybody out or gets hit. This is one of the coolest things ever to see him. I want the ball come out of the pen with such a great resume already. This is awesome.
Infante will lead it off. Can the Royals figure out Bumgarner? Ball one, up and away. And according to his manager, Bruce Bochy, 45-50 pitches is the usual side day for Bumgarner. But this situation, guys, is anything but usual.
A little bit different than the side day, huh? I think difficulty could be how long you go with him. What if he's throwing well?
On the inside corner, Infante didn't like it. One ball, one strike.
What a nasty cutter. This is a big sign right here. What kind of stuff does he have? Look at how far that ball's breaking. Now, you may wonder, what's a guy do on his side day? He usually just gets a nice work in, gets up a good lever, may work on something, but it's not usually maxed out. This is maxed out today.
That's in the air to right. Leadoff man is on.
Fastball at 93, up. Great approach by Infante, taking this ball the other way, head on the baseball.
I think the one adjustment that we have seen this game is hitters taking the ball the other way. A lot of guys are spinning off on pitches, no matter who the pitcher was earlier in the series. Tonight, staying with it and driving the ball the other way.
Back to the top of the order, Escobar. Ball one, down and away as he shows bunt. smothered by Posey. That got Sandoval moving from third.
That got me peeking to the on-deck circle.
Well, they like Aoki against left-handed pitchers. Bumgarner, not your normal lefty by any stretch of the imagination. Don't often see the bunt to move up left on left against Bumgarner.
Escobar's had good swings tonight. They throw over to see if Escobar will tip his hand.
And he did. And that's exactly right, Joe, what they're doing. They want to see, particularly with a left-handed pitcher, because as a hitter, you got to start. Once he lifts that leg, you got to start your pivot. And now he has the option to throw the first. They saw him give it up.
He gets out of the way of ball two.
After seeing that he was going to be bunting, he wants to bust him in with a cutter. In this situation with the third baseman in, you're looking to bunt at the first base. Bumgarner knows that. Nobody bunts more than a National League pitcher.
Still bunting on 2-0. Back to Bumgarner. Only play at first. One away. Tying run to second. As we come to the top of the hour, 9 o'clock here in the Central Time Zone, we'll give you a game summary. It's presented by PlayStation 4. Greatness awaits. Starters are gone. Tim Hudson went an inning and two-thirds. Michael Morse has had a big night. His RBI base hit into right, the difference in the game right now. And Bumgarner, who has dominated all postseason, comes in out of the bullpen. That's us. Tying run at second, one out. Here is Nori Aoki.
Oh, by the way, 0 for 16 against Madison Bumgarner.
Well, it's an interesting bunt play when you're down one in the fifth, but this is the way the Royals play. And it's hard to question it. They've gone to a game seven in the World Series.
But I'll say this. The way Escobar's been swinging, not just tonight, but throughout this series, it's a bit of a gamble by Ned Yost to take the bat out of Escobar's hands, bunt with Escobar, and right now leave it in the lap of Aoki, who is 1 for 12 in this World Series and hitless against Bumgarner. Ball one.
I'm with you. I didn't think it was the time to drop the bunt. You're only in the fifth. He's swinging the bat real well. But as we've seen, this is how they play.
Infante at second, one out. Ball two.
Clearly so far, 8 pitches in. Not the same command we're used to seeing from Bumgarner, one of the best strike throwers in the game. Not on point yet.
He's been behind all three hitters. There's a strike, 2-1 at 90 from the left-hander who was hitting as high as 94 on the radar gun. In game five.
Well, the two things you're going to suffer from if you're tired is your velocity and your location.
That's down the left field line. Caught. Perez, who's in there for his defense, makes a nice catch for out number two.
The positioning. As we've moved to game seven, you know where guys are going to hit the ball. Great jump, but also where they had him sitting, this ball off the bat, you're thinking double in the corner.
Think of where they've been with Ishikawa, who's still a novice in the outfield. And tonight, Bruce Bochy told us before the game, that slip by Ishikawa in the game last night. He said, that stove's hot. I'm not going back there and touching it. I'm going with defense tonight. It just paid off.
It's just too big of an outfield to defend. You need your best defensive outfield out there at all times.
Here's the best hitter for the Royals with runners in scoring position. Kane, strike one. He didn't like the call. Lorenzo Cain digs in there, hitting .462 with runners in scoring position this postseason, and you can see why I didn't like it.
Yeah, that ball's down.
Cain getting a good look. Now chases, 0-2, 93 from Bumgarner.
That's an excuse me swing. That's one of those high pitches that you think, because your eyes are so close, it looks good.
Now Cain has to protect. Able to lay off ball one. Madison Bumgarner has won in the World Series at the age of 21, the age of 23. He's 2-0 this World Series at the age of 25. Coming out of the bullpen. The 1-2. The tying run at second, two out, and a 1-2 count on Cain. We remind you tonight's telecast, sponsored by Chevrolet, find new roads. We got a long way to go in this one. Cain strikes out, and Bumgarner adds another scoreless inning. The Royals bunt in the inning. Aoki lined out. Cain strikes out. Still 3-2 Giants now after five.
Later, bud. Hey, I'm sorry. I decided I shouldn't drive home last night. I stayed at Dave's. I'm back. Yeah, I'm back.
When was the last time your wireless company made you feel like this? The new Cricket Wireless believes you should be doing a lot more of this. So we don't have any of those silly annual contracts. But we do have a whole lot of coverage for not a lot of money. So everyone can feel like this. Switch now and get a free 4G smartphone on our reliable 4G network after $50 mail-in rebate Cricket Visa promotion card. The new Cricket Wireless. Something to smile about.
Warm up to winter with a white chocolate delight from McCafe.
I don't care whether you have a PhD or an MBA, everyone has questions about money.
You know, I think about money kind of a lot.
Money's freedom.
Money's always on my mind. Credit cards.
Mortgage.
Debt.
It's complicated. It's not easy.
I'm not a good budgeter.
Unfortunately, I'm a spender.
I would love to learn more about finances.
So there's questions about the world that all of us have, especially about money and finance. The goal of Khan Academy and Better Money Habits and the partnership we're doing with Bank of America is to give people the tools they need to empower themselves.
It's Macy's lowest prices of the season, with specials now through Sunday. Get these dazzling half-carat total weight diamond earrings, now only $199. Save on Travel Select 7-piece spinner sets, only $97.99. Take an extra 20% off clearance shoes for her from Bandolino, Nine West, Alfani, and more. And all 8-piece bed ensembles from Fairfield Square Collection are now just $37.99. Get the lowest prices of the season now at Macy's.
Tonight's telecast is sponsored by AT&T Mobilizing Your World. By Budweiser, the official beer of Major League Baseball. Here's to Budweiser. Here's to baseball. And by McDonald's, I'm loving it. Aerial coverage provided by Goodyear. Everything Goodyear has learned making tires that go the distance inspires what they roll into yours. Goodyear, more driven. Herrera out for finished off the fourth, worked the fifth. The deal with Sandoval, who has not been retired tonight, he scored twice. Takes a strike. Just a finish on the bottom of the fifth inning after the base hit by Infante to start. Madison Bumgarner fell behind Alcides Escobar with a count of 2-0. The tying run at first, nobody out. Strike two. Ned Yost stayed with the bunt. I think the more aggressive play would be to see what Bumgarner has and not give him an out while he's behind on the count to a guy swinging it well at 2-0.
Yeah, you would think maybe a bunt for a hit if you want a bunt, or hit and run, or 2-0. Escobar swinging the bat.
Aoki lined out. Kane struck out. 3-2 game. Ball one on Sandoval.
I think there's two plays that will be discussed right now at this point. The panic play on the double play and then the Escobar bunt. Those are the two things that kind of stand out as plays in this game that have kind of made a big difference.
Well, especially when you're bunting up to an 0-for-16 matchup.
Talking about Aoki and Bumgarner. Here's a 1-2. That's another hit for Sandoval. On base for the third time tonight.
All leading off an inning.
Does he hit a strike? Of course not. Another pitch out of the zone.
Hard it is to hit that ball. 98 miles an hour up and away and running. Hand-eye coordination is incredible.
Now Sandoval hitting .413 in his World Series career. And Hunter Pence digs in. Might be. Could be. It is.
Well, that's a big play right here. I wasn't anticipating the double play from Herrera because he throws so hard and gets so many balls hit in the air. Tailor-made. Might be, could be, is.
Well,
like
for,
that.
For Herrera, that's big as they're worried about pitch count, him getting through this sixth inning, trying to get the game to Wade Davis, who's getting loose for the Royals out in their bullpen.
Yeah, I mean, the longest outing of his career is three innings. Talking about Kelvin Herrera.
Well, they got all winter to rest. This is it.
Here's Belt. 1-for-2 with a productive out his last time up. Deep enough to advance a runner to third. Fly ball to left and now takes a strike.
Well, he's pitching now too, huh? Dropping in breaking balls. We saw the changeup.
Yeah, he's got much better stuff tonight than he has the whole series.
That's foul. He came in, Herrera, in the fourth inning. With two on, one out. Ned Yost allowed Jeremy Guthrie, the starter, to face Belt with two on, nobody out after back-to-back hits. And Herrera was greeted by a base hit by Michael Morse for the lead. Belt's only home run this postseason, the game winner in the 18th inning. Game 2 divisional series tilt at Washington.
I keep looking for that ball inside that they just have buried in on him the whole series.
Here is a 1-2. That is a base hit into right. Belt on for the second time tonight. And the batter will be Michael Morse as Brandon Belt has gone 2-for-3 in game 7.
That's pretty impressive right there. You saw the breaking ball, first pitch for a strike, two changeups, and then got, here it is, 99. And he timed it. He was on it. Not inside where they've lived, more over the plate.
Yeah, this is a big miss by them right here, but Anytime you're facing a guy throwing that hard, you got to look fastball and adjust. The fastball is designed to stay in the zone. The breaking balls are not. So you look for that heater. Rod Carew caught that a number of years.
Here's Morse. One on, two out. Strike one. Two hits in the inning, but a double play ball in between. Big bats coming up for Kansas City in the bottom of this sixth. '97 foul back by Morse, strike two.
Yeah, you can tell he's getting a little tired. He's missing his spots. The base hit to Belt was a pitch that was missed. Look where Perez is setting up. Look where the ball runs to.
Sends game seven into the bottom of the sixth with the big bats coming up. It'll be Hosmer, Billy Butler, and Alex Gordon for the Royals, who trail by one.
This is the new iPhone 6.
And this is the new iPhone 6 Plus.
Have you seen some of the new stuff the camera can do?
Yeah, it's unbelievable.
Its slow-mo is
slower than ever before.
Its time-lapse can turn hours into seconds.
Image stabilization helps keep everything smooth.
So smooth.
The camera on the new iPhones are better than ever.
Shabba!
What was that?
That's the sound the camera makes.
No, it's more like a...
Nope, I think it's shabba!
In 1 week, your company will go into foreclosure, and I will own your business. We need to find $500,000 to get us our company back.
Boom! Kidnapping.
A kidnapping?
He's back together.
I was a little insulted. You only asked for $500,000 for me, and so I tacked on another zero.
$500 million?
Wow, that's $5 million.
Five million.
Horrible Bosses 2, rated R.
It's the $6.99 pick your pairs deal at Pizza Hut. Pick two medium pizzas and a total of four toppings for $6.99 each. Want two toppings on one and two on the other? Three and one? Get it however you want and on your favorite crust. Pan thin and crispy or hand tossed. Just $6.99 a pizza. Pizza Hut.
Everything I say, she takes to heart.
Ooh.
That's my daughter in the water. Every time she fell, I caught her. Every time she fell.
With Walmart's everyday low prices, you can help them find what they love and make every day count. Save money, live better. Walmart.
Esurance was born online, which means fewer costs, which saves money. Their customer experience is virtually paperless, which saves paper, which saves money. They have smart online tools, so you only pay for what's right for you, which saves money. They settle claims quickly, which saves time, which saves money. They drive an all-hybrid claims fleet, which saves gas, which saves money. They were born online and built to save money, which means when they save, you save. Because that's how it should work in the modern world. Esurance, backed by Allstate. Click or call.
Stay on top of the game 24-7, 365 with MLB Network and MLB.com, where baseball is always on. Live the drama of October. Celebrate 2014's best. And look ahead to 2015. It's all of baseball, all the time. On MLB.com and MLB Network, our national pastime, all the time.
An MLB record, 48 and two-thirds innings pitch this postseason for Madison Bumgarner. Hosmer was trying to tie it with one swing. Obviously, more opportunity for a guy like Bumgarner with extra rounds, but it's also for a pitcher more opportunity for failure. All he has done is deal, put up zeros. The 0-1. Strike two.
I just go back to the... Game one, Hosmer hits the ball to right center field that Blanco ran down when he was
is 0 for 3. I want to go back to the last out of the fifth inning. Lorenzo, watch how Bumgarner works him. Shows him the backdoor cutter, gets the call. And now keep an eye on Buster Posey. His target will be at the top of the strike zone. Every pitch coming out of the crouch to get these. And Bumgarner just doesn't miss. Upstairs and finally puts him away. Tremendous sequence by Bumgarner. Guys, I noticed the last few pitches. The grunt is back from Madison Bumgarner. He is dealing.
Here's Billy Butler. That went around the strike zone. Ball one to the guy who has been with this organization longer than anybody on this current Royals roster. One for two tonight. On the inside corner, Butler didn't like it. One ball, one strike.
So it was frustrating as a hitter. It's two at-bats now we've seen with Kane. On a ball that was down, chances at bat, and Butler not locking that ball up and in. It's a strike. So hang with it, Billy.
Breaking ball in for a strike at 87. It's 1-2.
That's been the biggest difference for me the last couple of years. Bumgarner working both sides of the plate. Naturally cuts the ball in on right-handers, and now that cut fastball away opens up the other side of the plate.
I think the one thing we're seeing right now, Joe, from Bumgarner is the rhythm that we saw as a starter in a couple games he dominated. Let's get the ball here it comes right now. He's in a nice groove.
Here's a 2-2. Think about where we are right now in this game with these two bullpens. Right now, Bochy's got his big weapon on the mound. And Madison Bumgarner trying to bridge the gap to the late innings. They have good guys down there. But the game right now is in the hands of Madison Bumgarner. On the other side, Ned Yost has used Kelvin Herrera. He's got Wade Davis getting ready. He'll take over, it appears, in the seventh inning. He's got his closer, Greg Holland, ready for more than an inning if he needs it here tonight.
Well, he said before the game, I'm going to use my guys, meaning the five guys he wanted with Bumgarner, Herrera, Davis, Holland, and Finnegan if he needed it. Those are the five he wanted out to shoot.
Here's a 2-2. Popped up into center field, shallow center, as Butler slams his bat down. Now the Geico in-game box score for the Kansas City Royals. RBI double in this game for Alex Gordon. That had to feel good for the guy who's digging in right now. Sack fly for Omar Infante, who also led off against Bumgarner last inning with a base hit, but he was left on. Here is Alex Gordon. He has an RBI double, a run scored, been hit by a pitch. Strike one.
If you're Kansas City, obviously you want people on base, but you really try to grind out at bats against Bumgarner. You know, 2 days of rest after throwing 117 pitches, you know there is a clock on him, a pitch count on him.
That is foul, third base side, long run, nobody will get there out of play.
So yeah. Even if you can't, you know, get a run against him, at least drive the pitch count up, make him work, try to get to somebody else in the bullpen.
Yeah, but he throws too many strikes, and he's in a groove right now. You find yourself down 0-2. That's the difference with this guy. Great theory, and I follow you. You want to ride him out, but you find yourself 0-2. You may as well take your shot if you get a pitch to hit.
In the air to center, Blanco is there. To his right, another scoreless inning put up by Madison Bumgarner. Continues to roll. It's a 3-2 game. Giants on top after six in game seven. Back after this from your local Fox station.
We're running out of time.
He means raise hell on earth. How does anyone come back from that? I keep going to forever.
200 years. No more haunting, baby.
To be your locally owned grocer, Price Chopper. Casey Pride lives here.
All right, Chiefs fans, it's game time at the Built Ford Tough sales event. And when it comes to trucks, stats don't lie. F-150 with EcoBoost has smash mouth power with efficiency. And with best-in-class payload, boom, F-150 hauls in the Hail Mary. And here's a stat, pal. F-Series has been America's truck for 37 straight years. And that's a dynasty, baby.
Get up to $87.50 total savings or 0 for 60 plus $4,500 total savings plus a no-charge powertrain service plan.
Has done it again. First, there was the Sprint Family Share Pack. A family of 2, 4, or even 10 gets unlimited talk, text, and 20 gigabytes of data to share with the entire family for only $100 a month. That's double the high-speed data of AT&T, Verizon, and T-Mobile. Double the data. And now check out Sprint's new unlimited plan. Individual lines of unlimited data, talk, and text at just $50 a month per line. Our lowest price ever. $100 a month for the family, $50 a month for individual lines. Sprint, it's the best value in wireless.
Ford gives you more for winter. Starting Thursday, tune into Fox 4 News in the morning for the word of the day. Then enter online for a chance to win an Aaron snowblower each week.
Royals World Series, only on Fox 4.
There's Steve Perry, eye black on yet again. It's Jordy Nelson, great receiver for Green Bay. It's Kansas State. Tom Watson, World Golf Hall of Famer, and George Brett is leafing through a book. That's the way he's dealing with the stress of this game seven as we go to inning number seven. Brandon Crawford will deal with Wade Davis, who was automatic all year long. It's gone Guthrie, Herrera, now Wade Davis. See that number, the guy who did not allow an extra base hit this season until the very end of July. That's inside. One ball, one strike.
That's a late cut on that ball right there. Tough to pick up.
It's Crawford now, then Juan Perez, then Gregor Blanco. Bullpen quiet for the Giants. That means more from Bumgarner. Strike two.
Yeah, we've seen some terrific arms tonight. And in this series in particular, but a game like tonight when everybody's on deck, you just see why these clubs were able to advance.
Each shot has needed only three pitchers to this point as the count evens 2-2.
I'm just amazed at Madison Bumgarner, guys. I mean, it's only the third time since 88 in the World Series somebody's made two starts and came out of the bullpen in relief, but he's already gotten him six outs. And it's still his ball game.
Here's a 2-2 to Crawford. Got him swinging, one away. In case you missed it, stay tuned. T-Mobile thanks the fans for being part of the Big Seven. One out in the top of the seventh. Bottom three in the order will bat for Kansas City in this inning. It'll be Perez, Moustakas, and Infante. Is it a stretch at this point to think Bruce Bochy could ride Madison Bumgarner all the way to Casilla, his closer here tonight.
Oh, no doubt, and he's being economic with his pitches right now, so he's got a shot.
Strike one on Juan Perez.
27 pitches for Madison Bumgarner to this point. They're talking about maybe getting 45 to 50.
Just don't see any stress. I mean, he's 267 innings into this season.
Here's a 1-1. Strike two.
Well, the innings is remarkable. When you start talking about pitch count, you got to take in account how big this kid is. And he can handle a big load.
6'5", 235. 1-2. 2 out.
Oh, boy. It is getting good. The pitching has changed the game. It has taken it to a whole nother level and a different stress level at that. They're all locking in right now.
Bring in Gregor Blanco, who's 0-3. It's a home run in this World Series. And Cam against Ventura here in game two. It feels like about 2 months ago. Strike one.
Seems like, Joe, you finish a sentence and you go strike one. That's what we've heard for the last two innings. It's incredible how well these guys are attacking the zone and putting the hitters on their heels.
Here's the 0-1. Why not? Try and change it up. Showing bunt, taking the ball down and in.
I hear you. Watching him pitch the other day for the first time in person, that cutter, second to none in the big leagues, just filthy.
That drills the outside corner at 95, strike two.
I know every time he throws that cutter, I'd ask to see the baseball because it seems lopsided.
And then right they can there, equalize it with that.
Exactly. Paint.
Two and two. Side, tough play. Escobar, nice play across his body to end the inning. And a 1-2-3 frame put up by Wade Davis.
This is the play he did not make in San Francisco. The difference, he took another step and caught it on the short hop and made the easy throw across the diamond. Right here, he went to go get it. He attacked it. San Francisco, he laid back, tried to barehand it. That backhand and missed it. That made the play.
So here we are, seventh inning stretch, game seven, a one-run game. Giants on top by one. And now for the introduction of God Bless America, we go to public address announcer Mike McCartney.
Fans, let's pause to celebrate our freedom and those who work to defend it. Please join us in singing God Bless America, being performed by Whiteman Air Force Base Master Sergeant Jennifer Sherman.
God bless America, land that I love. Stand beside through the night with the light from above. From the mountains to the prairies to the oceans white with foam. God bless America, my home sweet home. God bless America, my home sweet home.
T-Mobile asked millions of Americans take part in the Big 7. You sang, you uploaded. This is your moment.
Be out to the audience. Be out to the crowd. Find me some peanuts and crack a jack. I am a parent, my dad will be back for me. Look for the home team.
Hi, I'm Rob Lowe, and I have DirecTV.
And I'm super creepy Rob Lowe, and I have cable.
With DirecTV, you get 99% signal reliability.
Now that's reliable. My cable's out, so I'm down at the rec center watching folks swim.
I love that I can watch my shows and be worry-free.
And I love the smell of other people's hair.
Don't be like this me. Get rid of cable and upgrade to DirecTV. Call 1-800-DIRECTV.
Dear United States of America, I am 13 years old. This summer was the best summer of my young life. Out of this whole journey, the best part was having my family behind me, supporting me through everything I did. I have a passion for sports. Every day of the week, I'm playing soccer, basketball, or baseball. I stand for girls who want to play sports with the boys and to be a role model for people, young and old. I throw 70 miles per hour. That's throwing like a girl. Sincerely, your daughter, Monet Davis.
Tonight's telecast sponsored by Chevrolet. Find new roads. By T-Mobile, changing the game of wireless. And by DirecTV. You call yourself a sports fan, you got to get DirecTV. They are preparing the Commissioner's Trophy. The presentation at the end of this game. Madison Bumgarner is doing his best to secure it for the third time in 5 years for San Francisco. Breaking ball drops in to Salvador Perez, pitch number 28. It's strike one in the bottom of the seventh.
Well, you got to know with Bumgarner.
Strike two.
Executing that nasty breaking ball right there. Perez looking for one thing to do, hit a ball in the seats because he can't move.
He got Bumgarner for a home run back in game one. He's the only guy that's been able to solve Bumgarner in that way, knocking a run home. He hit it over the wall on the left. Now he goes into right. Hunter Pence is there, coming to get it. One out. With the bases empty, Moustakas will be the batter. Before the game, Mark Gubiza, a Remember, the 85 World Series champion Royals delivered the game ball with Jasmine Fowler of the Boys and Girls Club of Lawrence, Kansas. For nearly 20 years, Major League Baseball has partnered with Boys and Girls Clubs of America to provide kids with a world of opportunities. Each year, Boys and Girls Clubs provide more than 4 million kids with a chance to have a great future. Go to greatfutures.org to find out how you too can help. Strike one on Moustakas. Gubazai works such a great job with Victor Rojas, Fox Sports West. 132 wins for Mark with the Royals. Third on the team's all-time list behind Splittorff and Leonard. Here's the 0-2. That's the second strike to a guy that's nothing for two, and now in the hole is Moustakas with one out, nobody on, and Infante next. Now the 0-2, reaching for it, Sandoval with a backhand long throw. Got it. And the defense has been outstanding for the Giants tonight.
Shoot up his bat right there. Again, guys, I'm just astounded by the length they're getting out of Madison Bumgarner. Watch here, rare ball hit the other way from Moustakas. We've seen everything from Pablo Sandoval. He's a pesky leadoff hitter and a good defender tonight. This is what I'm talking about. Two starts and then pitch and relief. Randy Johnson, C.J. Wilson picking up four outs. Bumgarner just keeps going on and on. And guys, a big difference in this game, let's not forget. American League wins the All-Star game. Home field advantage is here. This is now three relief pitchers in this game that can pitch three innings because you're never forced with a decision about having to hit for them.
Here's a strike to Infante, who has the only hit so far against Bumgarner.
Affelt, Pereira, now Bumgarner, all able to work without their spot coming up in the order in the American League Park. Of course, we saw that in game four. The manager's forced to make decisions with the pitcher hitting.
That is foul. Strike two.
Starting the line already early in the seventh inning here. It was a half step and a dive for Sandoval, and he's already halfway down the line. See where he's starting at. He's going to make sure he takes away a double in this situation.
Pitch number 36. Strike three. Two strikeouts for Madison Bumgarner, and he has gone three scoreless. What a job. What a pitcher. What a World Series for big number 40, 3-2 after seven in game seven.
Moses, Ramesses keep each other safe, always.
After 400 years of slavery,
you must set them free
before it's too late.
Is that a threat?
Yes! Something is coming that is far beyond you and I.
Who's been telling you this?
God.
I am the God! I am the God!
Rated PG-13.
Sprint has done it again. First, there was the Sprint Family Share Pack. A family of 2, 4, or even 10 gets unlimited talk, text, and 20 gigabytes of data to share with the entire family for only $100 a month. That's double the high-speed data of AT&T, Verizon, and T-Mobile. Double the data. And now check out Sprint's new unlimited plan. Individual lines of unlimited data, talk, and text at just $50 a month per line. Our lowest price ever. Enjoy either plan with iPhone 6 for zero down. Sprint, it's the best value in wireless.
For most people, earning cash back ends here at the purchase. But there's a new card in town. Introducing the Citi Double Cash Card. It lets you earn cash back when you buy and again as you pay. That's cash back twice. It's cash back with a side of cash back. The Citi Double Cash Card. The only card that lets you earn cash back twice on every purchase. With 1% when you buy and 1% as you pay. With two ways to earn, it makes a lot of other cards seem one-sided.
In a friendly competition, when does the mercy rule come into effect? New Fusion Pro Glide, rebuilt with FlexBall technology, makes maximum contact and gets virtually every hair. Gillette. What's better than clicking into a fresh new blade? Never running out of them again. Get Gillette's best blades delivered to your door for about $1 a week at Gillette.com/subscribe. Gillette.
The DQ Chicken Strip Basket. They call it tenderloin. I call it hashtag delicious. They're like blizzard good. Is that too far?
Not at all, Alan. The Chicken Strip Basket, now only $4.99. This is fan food, not fast food.
I put my heart and guts into this company.
We built this empire from the dirt to the top.
I need one of you to man up and lead it.
Don't forget me, baby.
I want half my company back. It was my 400,000 that started this. I want what's mine.
No apology. I'm ensuring a legacy, and no one is going to tear it down.
Well, if he wasn't already prior to tonight, Madison Bumgarner, as Wade Davis brings it, panic, fouls it back. Madison Bumgarner is further identifying himself as one of the greatest World Series pitchers in the history of Major League Baseball.
There's no question. I said coming into this game, we'd see history. That's what Game 7 gives you. So both starting pitchers in the Game 7 out of there, less than 10 outs. We saw the first instant replay call at first base overturned. But guys, there's nothing like the history we're watching with that man right there. I don't know that we've seen anything like it, ever.
Here's a 1-1. Panic fights it off. Strike two.
Well, the one thing I was saying is I thought it was cool because you just don't see this in this day and age with pitch counts and everything else and the worry of a young pitcher coming back like he does, to be able to pitch in a situation like this, it's incredible.
And that's why I say ever. You know, Christy Mathewson, Babe Adams, back in the dead ball era, sure, they pitched all the time. These guys are not trained to pitch on 2 days rest like this.
That's on the outside corner. Panic strikes out looking, one away in the eighth.
You know, guys, we marveled all series about the Giants putting the ball in play with two strikes. And Wade Davis has come in and just put that to rest real quick. When you have that kind of control and accuracy with the precision of power, very difficult at bat.
Here's Posey now. He's 0 for 3 tonight. Strike one. The pitching of Bumgarner and what's happened here tonight, and the pitching of Bumgarner in the two previous starts renders almost everything else moot. I mean, you've got a guy who is the leader of this Giants team and Buster Posey. It's really struggling with the bat, looking for his first extra base hit of this entire postseason as he grounds out to Infante. And it doesn't matter because of what Madison Bumgarner has done in the two starts in the relief work here tonight.
And think about all the trouble they've had with every other starting pitcher not named Bumgarner. He is covering a multitude of errors throughout the roster. With some help from this man right here, Pablo Sandoval, the key to the offense tonight.
Well, you look at Sandoval and Pence, the series they've had. Any other year, you're saying MVP series. They played that great. Is there a question if the Giants win who the MVP is? I mean, Madison Bumgarner has been that great.
Bumgarner came in 2-0 with an ERA of 0.56 in two starts this World Series. Opponent sitting 127 against him. Sandoval takes a strike. 13 strikeouts, one walk. The other starters have made four starts, gone 0-3 with an ERA of 9.82. Now up to 9.92. You see the opponent's average. There's another hit for Sandoval. On base for the fourth time tonight. And he will dig into second base with a two-out double. And if this is his last game as a San Francisco Giant, the question is, how do they replace somebody that's been this good for this long at this time of year in San Francisco if he walks away?
Well, you don't. That's the answer. You don't know what you're going to get. And if you look around Major League Baseball, third base is one of the weakest positions in the big leagues. It's been a big decline in the last 3 or 4 years of the production at third base. That vaults his value that much higher.
What stays with me is that look and that wink on his face before he took his first at-bat of the game, almost as if he knew how this game would play out.
Runner at second, two out. That's a big run sitting out there for the Giants, leading by one. By the way, there's nobody getting loose for the Giants in their bullpen here in the eighth. Runner at second, two out. Peck, strike one.
Does he swing hard or what?
There's the wink. Infante. Off we go. Bottom of the eighth inning, game seven. Off he goes. Back to work. Off comes the jacket. Top of the order for the Royals. Down by one.
MasterCard is a longtime proud sponsor of Major League Baseball. And now, fans who use their MasterCard with Apple Pay could get a priceless surprise. Even at the World Series. From VIP experiences to meeting a legend.
Hey, Mr. 85.
How are you? Use your MasterCard with Apple Pay.
Oh, no way!
You could get a priceless surprise.
This is crazy.
I can't even believe it.
There are more reasons than ever why now is the best time to be on Verizon. One, Verizon's the largest, most reliable 4G LTE network in the country. That's right, America. With XLTE in over 400 markets. Two, and here's something for families to get excited about. Our best ever pricing with double the data on select plans. And three, you can now get our best ever single line pricing starting at $45. So get all this now on the network ranked number one for data performance nationwide. Verizon.
Taco Bell's Beefy Fritos Burrito. Crunchy Fritos, seasoned beef, and warm nacho cheese sauce, all for just a buck.
Don't adjust your television. The new way to Taco Bell isn't on TV. It's only in the app.
Now, Centrum Silver has a new easy-to-swallow coating. So the nutrients for your eyes, heart, and brain go down easier. For a limited time, get your $4 coupon at Centrum.com.
Away. Away is the smell of victory. And the smell of burgers. Away is always having home field advantage. Even when you're miles away from home. Find your away. For a dealer in the RV that's right for you, visit GoRVing.com.
VivoVet gently reminds you to get moving. Join the movement.
Tonight's telecast is sponsored by Garmin VivoFit. Join the movement. By Taco Bell. Sometimes you gotta live Moss. And by MasterCard. Anytime, anywhere you use your MasterCard, you could get a priceless surprise. Aerial coverage provided by Goodyear. Everything Goodyear has learned, making tires that go the distance, inspires what they roll into yours. Goodyear, more driven. Madison Bumgarner, the lowest World Series ERA ever at 0.26. And he is out there with 268 innings pitched under his belt in 2014. Nobody up in the bullpen, top of the order. Madison's Giants up by one. Escobar takes a ball. Came on the air talking last night about the Royals, and if you thought down 3-2 they were intimidated, coming back home, this young group was not. They went out and won 10-0. this was a team that beat the A's in the wild card game 9-8 in 12 innings. They were down 7-3 in the eighth inning to John Lester, and down again 8-7 into the bottom of the 12th, and Ned Yost's team came back to win it, and that's why they're here. Now they have to figure out Bumgarner. A 1-1 to Escobar. Strike two, and that got Posey.
That eighth inning, Joe, of that wild card game, that's when Ned Yost said his team believed it was a championship team. Not any time before, not September, not the first seven innings of that game, but the eighth inning of the wild card game.
Well, you see the foul tips these catchers take. You wonder when their offense disappears, why it disappears. So many things that make it work.
Look at what the bullpens have done tonight. Scoreless. Here's the 1-2. That's outside. Remember the last time Escobar was up after a leadoff hit with Bumgarner just in the game. Man on, nobody out, a 2-0 count. The Royals kept the bunt on with Escobar. Bumgarner's been rolling since. He went away. And a strikeout starts the eighth.
Well, we watched him go up the ladder earlier. Question is, does he go? That's tough.
I think that's a good call by Eric Cooper. Watch the barrel. Generally, an umpire on the lines are looking right down the line, and if the barrel crosses the visual of the foul line, they will ring you up. And that happened right there.
That's about as close as it gets. That's a tough one to read.
Strikeout number three for Bumgarner. Here's Aoki. The Royals bunted Infante into scoring position for back in the fifth, and he lined out to left. Ball one inside. On the outside corner, ball and a strike at 91.
Well, you can see why he's so tough to hit. Busts him in, then he goes back outside. He puts you in almost a rocking chair position as a hitter to anticipate one side of the plate. He takes it away from him.
That's out of play, strike two. So the count 1-2 with one out, nobody on. And this Saturday, two of the Pac-12's best teams collide. Stanford takes on Heisman hopeful Marcus Mariota and fifth-ranked Oregon. The Ducks try to keep their playoff hopes alive in a key divisional battle. Coverage begins 6:30 Eastern right here on Fox and streaming live on Fox Sports Go. Aoki checks on Crawford. Out number two. And now it's Lorenzo Cain, two out, nobody on.
Now 12 batters Bumgarner has faced. 11 pitches, that's it, out of the strike zone. Just amazing what we're watching right now.
Greg Holland getting ready for the top of the ninth inning while Bumgarner has retired 11 straight. What he's doing just makes you shake your head. Incredible to watch. As ball one misses down and in.
Plus he gave up a hit to the first guy he faced tonight and then slammed the door.
And just the third pitcher since the early 20th century with two or more wins as a starter, three or more innings as a reliever. And he's throwing hard still, gets it by the bat of Lorenzo Cain. One ball, one strike.
My goodness. When you have to go all the way back more than 100 years to the dead ball era, to find anything like this. If you didn't know already, you know we're watching something special.
Bumgarner on 1-1. Cain takes strike two. Question is right now for Bruce Bochy, how do you take him out?
Ooh, it'd be hard to do.
Santiago Casilla, the closer's barely pitched in this series. The 1-2. Fouled away.
Well, he's in such a great rhythm, Joe. He fell into that the second inning he pitched. It seemed like he was back to that rhythm he was in when he was a starter in game one and the other games he pitched in. He's been fantastic game five. Terrific.
Kane battling him here with two out, nobody on, and a 1-2 count. Santiago Casilla, the closer for the Giants, has thrown four pitches in this World Series that started 8 days ago.
It's an agonizing decision. You got to start thinking about it now.
On top of that, he could be faced with an inning in the ninth inning where two of the first three batters are left-handed batters.
This is the kind of the bat I've been looking for from Kansas City. Grinding out in the bat, slowing Bumgarner down, making him throw extra pitches, hoping there's a payoff somewhere.
Popped him up, got it in on the hands, panic. Ends the eighth. And the ninth inning rolls in. Wow. About all you can say from Madison Bumgarner. Wow. 3-2 Giants after eight in game seven.
Toenail fungus? Don't hide it. Fight it with new FDA-approved Jublia. Jublia, efinaconazole 10% topical solution, is a prescription medicine proven to treat fungal infections of the toenails. Use Jublia as instructed by your doctor. Most common side effects include ingrown toenail, application site redness, itching, swelling, burning or stinging, blisters, and pain. Fight it! Ask your doctor now if new Jublia is right for you.
Just like every spring has its finales, every fall has its premieres.
This is war.
This is awesome.
Shh. Okay.
Get more Fall TV with Hulu Plus. Start your free week now.
America. God shed his grace on me. Oh, he crowned my good with brotherhood. From sea to
It's Straight Talk Wireless, which means you get unlimited talk, text, and data for only $45 a month. No contracts, no surprises.
What about hidden fees?
Nope.
What about funny business?
No.
Bamboozling?
What is bamboozling?
It's like a malarkey.
No.
Good.
Same phone, same networks, half the cost. Get an Alcatel One Touch Pop Icon on America's largest and most dependable 4G LTE networks. Unlimited talk, text, and data is just $45 a month. The world needs more Straight Talk, only at Walmart.
I'm not sure what I'm more afraid of, them never coming back.
Here we go.
Or coming back to find we've failed.
Then let's succeed.
You can't just think about your family. Now you have to think bigger than that.
Stay down.
I am thinking about my family and millions of other families.
I love you forever.
Do that better than any human in history.
Hang on!
I'm coming back.
Interstellar, rated PG-13, in theaters and IMAX November 7th.
It's back for a limited time. Enjoy America's boldest steak and classic steamed lobster or Old Bay butter lobster on the barbie, starting at just $14.99.
And on Halloween, when you buy an entree, you'll unleash a free kid's meal.
It's a scary good deal.
One hit in four innings for Bumgarner. He and the Giants have a one-run lead as Greg Holland, the closer for the Royals, takes over strike one on Brandon Belt. Underway in the ninth inning. 3-2 Giants trying to wrap up their third world championship in the last 5 years. Numbers for Holland this postseason. 7-for-7 in save chances, and all he's trying to do is 3-2.
Give it to one run game. That way one swing can tie it for you.
In the bottom of this ninth inning, 4, 5, and 6 hitters for the Royals. Hosmer, Butler, and Gordon. Nobody up in either pen. To the right side, Infante. 1-1. Caps, hoodies, jerseys, jackets, and more. Get all the officially licensed World Series gear for the Giants, Royals, and all of baseball at the MLB.com shop.
Well, that was a tough in-between hop for Infante right there. Backing up to get a good hop. That ball got back in on it.
Wade Davis went 2 innings, no runs, 1 hit, 3 strikeouts, no walks. Herrera, 2 2/3, no runs, 3 hits, 4 strikeouts. Here's Michael Morse. Strike one. It's the RBI by Morse on a ball thrown by Kelvin Herrera that is still holding up from back in the fourth inning.
A loop hit to right field on an 0-2 count. Herrera gave up only 5 hits all year on 0-2 counts.
Strike two. On deck, Brandon Crawford. Two up. Well, there's a game summary. Hudson lasted only an inning and 2/3. Bumgarner has taken care of all the work after Jeremy Affeldt went 2 1/3. 0.26 career World Series ERA for Bumgarner, and by far the biggest defensive play of the night. And since it's game 7 of the series, with a man on, nobody out, panicked to his right, took a hit away, and got a double play. That was in a 2-2 game back in the third inning. As Crawford takes ball one.
Yeah, so many things happened on that play, the flip out of the glove, but also Hosmer, thinking the ball was going through, started to angle a turn, and then he had to get back in the base path and ends up getting doubled up.
Here's a 1-0 to Crawford, 2-0.
How about the second out in that double play? Upon further review, the first overturned call on the field of play in World Series history.
Successful challenge by Bruce Bochy. Here's a 2-0. 2-1. Bruce Bochy tonight, guys. We've already talked about how he's headed for the Hall of Fame. He lifted Hudson in the second. He went to Affeldt for 2 1/3. And it's been Bumgarner the rest of the way with the lead. Madison is taking care of the rest to this point. 2-1, 2-2.
That's been terrifically managed. I think the only question will be the bunt with Escobar that maybe Ned Yost has to answer. Other than that, there's not a whole lot to question these guys on in this game. Like Ned's done all series, he'll answer it how he thinks fit.
Here comes a 2-2. Full count. Here's the decision for Bochy. The decision, by the way, has been made. Bumgarner's going back out there. But his closer, Santiago Casillo, has appeared in 19 straight postseason games. without allowing a run. But it's going to be Bumgarner. And we'll see him next. Here we go. Heart of the order for the Royals. Bottom of the ninth. One-run game. In game seven of the World Series.
John and Horace Dodge launched their first car in 1914. But they were not only business partners. They were brothers. Competitive. Stubborn. And always pushing each other the way only brothers can.
I've always loved exploring and looking for something better. That's the way I look at life, especially now that I live with a higher risk of stroke due to AFib,
a type of irregular heartbeat not caused by a heart valve problem. I was taking warfarin, but I wondered if I kept digging, could I come up with something better? My doctor told me about Eliquis for three important reasons. One, in a clinical trial, Eliquis was proven to reduce the risk of stroke better than warfarin. Two, Eliquis had less major bleeding than warfarin. And three, unlike warfarin, there's no routine blood testing.
Don't stop taking Eliquis unless your doctor tells you to, as stopping increases your risk of having a stroke. Eliquis can cause serious and in rare cases, fatal bleeding. Don't take Eliquis if you have an artificial heart valve or abnormal bleeding. While taking Eliquis, you may bruise more easily, and it may take longer than usual for any bleeding to stop. Seek immediate medical care for sudden signs of bleeding, like unusual bruising. Eliquis may increase your bleeding risk if you take certain medicines. Tell your doctor about all planned medical or dental procedures.
Those three important reasons are why Eliquis is a better find for me.
Ask your doctor today if Eliquis is right for you.
What is that?
It's when Dale call.
If you're on a diet of taking it up a notch,
that's way better than my doctor.
Drink Diet Dew, the only diet with dew in it.
What are you gonna sing?
Well, I have Paramore under my sleeve.
Is that uncomfortable?
Yes, yes, and yes.
He came on in the fifth. He allowed a leadoff hit, and since then, this 25-year-old master in the World Series has been untouchable. He has retired 12 straight. In game one as a starter during one stretch, he retired 12 straight. 10 straight in game five. But now here, with 2 days of rest, he is gunning for a five-inning save.
They drafted him in 2007. In his first spring training, they said, you can't throw that way with that slingshot delivery. Sent him to A-ball, didn't do well in three starts, and he said, guys, I need to go back to the way I throw. There's nobody who throws like Madison Bumgarner. That's never been more true than tonight.
Here's Hosmer. Ball one down and away. Two and one.
I go back to the ball that Hosmer hit in game one to right center field. I keep thinking about that in my mind, that he is thinking, I can hit this guy if I get the pitch I want.
That's going to get out of play to make the count two and two.
Don't forget, if the Royals get a runner on, Ned Yost, a couple of speed burners on that bench. Terrence Gore, Gerard Dyson.
Looks like he heard you. He looked around for him.
One away! 92-mile-per-hour fastball strikeout number four.
Well, we've watched him climb the ladder. That's been his out pitch. We watched him with Kane. We watched him with Escobar. And now he goes up top and he gets Hosmer to chase. Oftentimes you talk about an out pitch and think it's going to be the breaking ball. He has used the fastball to elevate and take their aggressiveness and use it against them.
Now Billy Butler. Ball one upstairs.
This is the toughest matchup for Bumgarner. Billy Butler handles the ball inside extremely well. 3-for-7 with a home run off Bumgarner.
Breaking ball drops in for strike one. Butler tonight 1-for-3 on the season, hit 9 home runs. Has not gone deep this postseason. Popped up right side. Will it stay in play? It does. 2 out. Brandon Belt is there, and the Giants are 1 out away from their third world championship in 5 years. It's up to Alex Gordon. Giants took the lead while Affeldt was in there. The official score is telling us that the win would go to Madison Bumgarner, which would make him 3-0 in this World Series. Here's the 0-1. That's in the air to left center. That ball is down. And it gets passed to the wall. Gordon is going to dig for third. Presenting the tying run.
Well, you see here, you talk about the mistake. He charged too hard. You're already playing no doubles, and that's exactly what it means. You don't want the ball by him. Blanco charged, got caught in between, and then the slip allowed the ball to get by him. Right here, the decision to try to stop and then slipping, and the ball goes by him. He's better off waiting. Keep the ball in front of you. Keep that runner at first base.
It's the right decision to let the ball drop, but he made it too late and wasn't able to handle the short bounce.
It's a single, E8. And now it's Salvador Perez, who could tie it with a hit. Two from Bumgarner, strike one. A man who has been the rock behind home plate for the Royals all year. With a chance to tie it. Able to lay off. 1-ball, 1-strike. Salvador Perez drilled by a pitch back in the second. The left leg almost couldn't continue, and here he is. Strike two.
He continues to climb the ladder for his out pitch, and they continue to chase it.
Tying run at third, two out, ninth inning. The 1-2. 2-2. Bumgarner now up to 66 pitches here out of the bullpen in game seven. Pitch number 290 in this World Series for Madison Bumgarner.
And he's not changing his pattern, Joe. He's just here it is, hit it, but he continues to climb the ladder, try to use their aggressiveness.
Salvador Perez, the 2-2. Francisco Giants for the third time in the last 5 years, and their hero, Madison Bumgarner. Bruce Bochy, in his eighth year as manager of the San Francisco Giants, now has his third world championship. Brian Sabian, the general manager, the architect, putting these teams together, moving parts, switching pieces. And we'll let that celebration play out in the middle of this diamond. But guys, it's hard to put into words and into perspective what we saw this postseason, let alone this World Series from Madison Bumgarner.
I'm just in awe. I mean, truly great history is not subtle. It smacks you in the face. You know it at the time you're watching it. You're seeing something that's for the ages. And that's what we saw watching Madison Bumgarner pitch. Never seen anything like it. I don't think we'll ever see anything like it again.
Especially in this day and age where the pitch count is so important and so impressed in our game. To see him want the ball and fight to not come out of a game, it's incredible.
Did you see that little look that Buster Posey gave Madison Bumgarner when that pitch was popped up into the air? And who more appropriate to catch it than Pablo Sandoval, the free agent to be? He got their offense started all night long. We go down to the field with Madison Bumgarner and Ken Rosenthal.
Thanks, Joe. Madison, you told me earlier today that this was not going to be that big a deal. But when you came to the park, how many innings did you realistically expect to pitch?
Innings wasn't, I wasn't thinking about innings or pitch count. I was just thinking about getting outs. Thanks, buddy. I love you. Getting outs until I couldn't get them anymore, and we needed someone else. So. Fortunately, we was able to get some quick innings, and I was able to stay in there.
Now that you've done it, what was it like? What was the difference between this and starting?
Well, there's not near as much time to dial it in, and that was the biggest thing for me. It was, I had a half inning to start getting up and getting loose and throwing all the pitches and stuff. So that was different, not having as much time, but luckily we was able to squeak by.
You end up throwing 270 innings on the season, over 50 in the postseason. How tired are you right now?
Right now, I'm not tired at all, man. Jeez. We just won the World Series. It's hard to be tired right now. Probably tomorrow I'll be tired now.
All right, Madison, thanks a lot.
All right, thank you.
Let's go over to Aaron Andrews.
Kenny, thanks so much. I'm here right now with Buster Posey, who I just said you look very emotional, but you said, I am spent. I can imagine. Take me to the bottom of the fifth. Madison Bumgarner comes in. What did you realistically anticipate you would get out of him tonight?
I mean, just me thinking along with, trying to think along with Boach. I was thinking maybe three, you know, maybe get three out of him and turn it over to Romo, Lopez in the eighth, and have Cassia in the ninth, but he just kept rolling. I mean, it's unbelievable.
He gets into a rhythm. What kind of conversation was there with you and Bruce Bochy, Dave Righetti, anybody?
Not much of anything. I think everybody could see that how good he was. They weren't putting great swings on him. I just can't say enough about how hard it is to do what he just did, to pitch five innings after 2 days rest or whatever he's on. It's incredible.
I saw you go over and talk to him right before he went out there for the ninth. What was said?
We were just talking about the first three that we were going to face and just trying to have a game plan going into it, and he executed it.
Congratulations, by the way. Great job. Congratulations.
Thanks.
Kenny, over to you.
Thanks, Aaron. Mike, before the game, you were as excited as I've ever seen you. Not surprisingly, it was game seven. You had two RBIs, including what proved to be the game winner. How did you calm yourself down to produce?
You know, it's unreal. You know, big moments like this, it's awesome. You know, this is what we fought for all year, and this is, the greatest group of guys I've ever seen. And from day one, we believed in ourselves. You know, when others didn't, we stuck by each other. And just a group of guys like that gets you to relax and calm you down, you know. And, you know, we fought. We fought our way to get here, and it's well-deserved.
What did you think of Mr. Bumgarner?
Oh, man. He's incredible. He's incredible. He's a different human being. I mean, it's unbelievable. You know, yesterday I asked him, I told him, you know, if you're going to go out there tomorrow, you know, you better bring it. And he said, just watch me. So, you know, this guy, every start, he gets better and better. And this is what, you know, this is what you get. What you see is what you get.
After last night, obviously a tough loss. You had this crowd to deal with. You had the Royals to deal with. What did you think coming into this game?
You know, I knew it was going to be a nail biter. I knew it was going to be tough. It hasn't been easy. You know, even though the games that have been blown out and stuff, it's been tough. It's been a fight. It's been a battle. And they're a heck of a ball club. You know, in this atmosphere, this place, it gets loud. You know, luckily I had some guys here that done this before. You know, so you know, experience for these guys, it helped calm some of us down.
Mike, congratulations. Joe, back to you.
Think about Michael Morse dealing with a strained oblique, wasn't even activated into the NLCS. Had that big game five home run off the bench tonight, drove home two of the three runs. Bruce Bochy, the master of the touch with his pen. His best move tonight, to not touch. Leave Madison Bumgarner in there. One of the greatest clutch performances we have ever seen or read about in World Series history. Number 40, the 25-year-old Madison Bumgarner, the winner tonight. Giants win it all. Trophy presentation coming up.